Morning and welcome to the VA Showcase. This is our monthly television show here on Berks Community Television, where we try to help educate you on veterans benefits for veterans and family members. If you'd like to call in and talk with us, the home viewer line here at the show is 610-378-0426, and I always want to thank Berks Community Television for helping to put this show on. Today, we're going to be talking about the upcoming Berks County Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance. And with me here in the studio is my friend and fellow committee member, Dave Zerbe. Dave, you're the owner of Dave Zerbe Studio Photography here in Reading, and have been also working in the U.S. Army Reserve and active duty before that for many, many years, lots of deployments, and now you're retired, and you're like me as a military retiree. We're staying busy, and yeah, that's right. You still own your business, and you still have all that work, but then we add this on the agenda every year, and this is our 15th year with this Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, thank you for inviting me, and it's a pleasure to talk about this event, and you know, it's such a neat event to get involved in, and I've been doing it for several years now, and just going out and taking the photographs of the event and then bringing that to life later on. It's just really great to see those images and the people the day of having a good time.
Yeah. So right off the bat, why don't we mention to the audience that we're talking about the Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance to be held on Saturday, November 12th at the Wilson High School Gymnasium from 4:00 to 10:00. Buffet dining is available to folks starting right at 4:00 when the doors open. And then at 5:00, between 5 and 6:00, there's a formal program, which we hope you'll enjoy too. And there's live big band orchestra music that's available. And there's also DJ Norm, who plays in between sets and later on in the evening. So Saturday, November 12th is what we're talking about, the big event, the annual Veterans Appreciation Dinner and Dance. You know, Dave, I've been told by the folks at Fort Indian Town Gap that this may be the largest indoor veterans appreciation event in the state.
Yeah, and also Commissioner Weinbach mentioned it possibly might be in the United States the only veterans appreciation dance like this.
Yeah, it could be the only dance of its type.
Yeah, right. I was amazed that he said that yesterday. So,
and this is for all veterans of all eras, from mm-hmm. World War II forward to today. It's not just for any one particular target group of veteran. It's for all veterans, family members, widows, widowers mm-hmm. of veterans, and just friends and family in the neighborhood who really would like to come on out and help celebrate the fact that you and I laced up the boots, went in the military, and served for a lot of years. Me, it was 23 years. You, it was over 30.
36 years, 7 months, and 2 days, to be exact.
Not counting, right.
Yeah. But, you know, there's a lot of groups that come to this, you know, VA groups, mm-hmm. veterans groups, and they come, and you know, you can actually get a table.
Yeah, we can reserve tables for you. All we have to know is how many people, and we'll give you an idea of where you're going to be seated. And you just give us a call at the Berks County Department of Veterans Affairs, and we'll have that number up later, and you can get that information coordinated, and we'll make sure that you have a reserved table as a group.
Right, and you know, the doors open at 4:00, but people start to gather earlier mm-hmm. in the foyer. So this year, we're going to have hors d'oeuvres waiting for you, and some water when you come through the door, and hopefully your wait to get through the main door will be pleasurable.
And we also have students inside while you're in the buffet line waiting, and they're going to be assisting you and helping answer questions mm-hmm. and those kinds of details that folks who may be arriving for the first time, joining us for the first time, they might have questions and such. And we get a lot of support from the Wilson School District, don't we?
Exactly. I mean, especially the school district itself, but mainly the JROTC, Army JROTC, that program that they have over there, over 100 kids.
Yeah, 120 kids. The Junior ROTC program is an Army-focused program. It produces young men and women who go into the military, but not everybody goes on. But everybody benefits from the wonderful Junior ROTC program. Wilson, like those around the state and in Berks County too, they really do a lot about getting kids who might otherwise be detached from a good academic track, or they might become disciplinary problems, things like that. They get into this, and others are just very focused, highly motivated folks, but then they come together. And the first semester of a ninth grader, and they help put on this event. Mm-hmm. You describe them as bees flying everywhere.
Yeah, they are. But, you know, a lot of them come from military background.
They do.
Yeah, and that's the neat thing, you know, they follow the footsteps of either their father or mother, and they come in that program, and you know, some of them go on to serve in the military and others don't, so they go to college and do other things.
But they really help to make the evening special.
Exactly.
They'll be providing a drill demo along in the evening, where you'll be impressed at how they can perform and show you how they come together in drill performance. It's pretty impressive. But out in front of that is going to be the POW MIA table and the ceremony that the cadets put on. It's for all of us in the military and generally for all Americans, it's a very meaningful mm-hmm. part of any social evening, like we're putting on, and we don't want to forget those men and
That's
women
right.
Who are still missing in action, and then of course remember all the folks who served in prison camps during war
right.
as POWs too. Mm-hmm. And then we get into something called the Military Hall of Fame.
Right, the inductees.
Yeah, Berks County has a Military Hall of Fame, and as of this year, there will be 48 members of the armed forces who have been recognized by the Berks County Board of Commissioners, and it became members of the Berks County Military Hall of Fame. There'll be six additional mm-hmm. Members this year. One was awarded the Navy Cross for Valor in the Vietnam War, another one the Distinguished Flying Cross in World War II, another one the Distinguished Service Cross in World War II, and then three Silver Star recipients between the Korean War, World War II, and the Vietnam War. Just hearing their stories every year and their heroism or their very, very special achievement is very fulfilling, and I hope you can join us to get there.
You know, it's amazing how many war veterans, I mean, decorated, highly decorated war veterans we have in Berks County.
Yeah, and we're one of the few counties that has a Military Hall of Fame. Most counties they have all kinds of different special programs, but we have a Military Hall of Fame now. Effective the dinner dance, we'll have 48 members in that Hall of Fame. Pretty mm-hmm. special.
Yes,
pretty
it
special.
Is. Dan, why don't you start rolling the background video, and then we can talk as we go. You know.
Okay.
I think we're experiencing some technical difficulty. Should just start there. There you go. Yeah. All right. Sorry about that. November 12th, 4 p.m. And, you know, this here is we transformed the whole Wilson High School gym into a big ballroom, which is absolutely gorgeous. And here's the people waiting, you know, they're waiting to get into the main ballroom. And a lot of veterans, a lot of World War II, Korean, Vietnam, you know, and so forth. They all come in and celebrate with us, and we appreciate every one of them.
They're the volunteer servers. They're always a special group, too.
They come from all over the place. Matter of fact, some of them come from the Albright College right here on this campus.
That's our committee chair, Jeff Elliott. Committee member, Dave Siscon. The sword arch. Many people have never gone through a sword arch, and that's especially if you're going through there with your spouse or your girlfriend, boyfriend. It's a special moment. The Let's Dance Orchestra is outstanding.
Yeah, they are. That's a big band orchestra, and they really, really are great, and we have them every year. They do a great job.
And they play music from all eras.
Yeah, they do.
Not just World War II.
And these were the inductees. Those were the inductees from last year. And then it's funny, we have cadets that went on to go to college at Norwich and West Point and things like that. You know, they come out of this JROTC group. And it's just such a neat appreciation dinner dance, and you know, and the formal program really highlights, you know, the military itself, and you know, they do their drill and ceremony, and then here's the table for the MIA POW, and the people really sit there and just love the whole presentation. So. And then here's the awards given by the commissioners. That's Commissioner Leinbach. And then Commissioner Barnhart's in the background there. And our commissioners actually, you know, they come and participate every year. And
yeah, it's important, I think, to continue to remember our veterans while they're living. Mm-hmm. We have 89 monuments, war memorials around the county.
Not many, wow.
But those are remembering the names of those who died in the line of duty. But while folks are alive and in our community, this is our day. This is Veterans Day.
We also give, from this dinner dance, we also give back to different nonprofit organizations in Reading that support veterans.
Yep. And our committee. Not that many to do all this work, but we enjoy doing it.
And I gotta say, without the JROTC, they you know, like I said, they're busy bees. And on the Thursday and Friday before the dinner dance, they're out there decorating this whole hall and
they pull it together.
They really do a great job.
Yeah. And they do it willingly and eagerly.
Right.
Which is always so much fun to see. And we have a lot of good feedback from them. They like being part of something like this.
And they're proud. I mean, they're really proud of it. And you know, and I think we're proud of them for what they do. You know?
Yeah, the evening does highlight the military service. These future members who may be cadets who may be members of the armed forces. And just to get to know people and catch up with people that you haven't seen in a long time. It's just a come together event right here in Berks County. We also invite folks from residential living at the Lebanon VA Medical Center, at the Coatesville VA Medical Center, and also at the Southeastern Pennsylvania Veterans Center, which is a personal care and nursing home. Down in Chester County. And we bring those folks in and they have a great time and students dance with them, even if they're in a wheelchair. It doesn't matter. They go home and they just talk about this for a
while. Right, there's an image of them dancing with them in a wheelchair. So
here they are. And, and then we get into the dancing.
Yep.
And there are people who come back every year primarily for the dancing.
For the dancing, right. They just enjoy it.
Just couples who have a hard time finding places where they can dance. And there's my wife and me, and we have just a great time each year.
And that's the first sergeant. The first sergeant is the one who takes care of the JROTC along with... a gentleman called Colonel Mike Dietrich, and they oversee all that, and they do a great job with these kids. And there's that Sergeant Major, Marine Sergeant Major, who shows up every year with that
Master,
beautiful
Master Gunnery Sergeant. If Frank is watching here, he'll want us to make sure we have
it. Right. I'm sorry about that. Yeah,
Master Gunnery Sergeant.
So you can't be too young or too old to attend this Veterans Appreciation Dinner, because, you know, we have a lot of veterans, you know, even currently now with the Iraqi or what we call Enduring Freedom. What was the other?
Operation Iraqi Freedom, New Dawn.
Yeah.
There are three others since then, too. They're
right.
Just smaller campaigns. And so there are a lot of younger men and women who have come out of the military too, and we'd love to get to know you.
Yeah.
To please encourage them to, and if you know somebody who's serving in the reserves, in the guard, and they live locally, who might want to come out, we'd love to have them.
Right.
This is not just for the veterans. We'd love to have the men and women who are mm-hmm. serving. If somebody's home on leave, we'd love to have them too.
Right.
We probably should talk about ticket sales, where people should...
Yes. We almost forgot about that, but that's very important.
Yeah. So Boskov's partners with us, mm-hmm. And tickets are on sale at the customer service desks at the three Boskovs here in Berks County. You go to the customer service desk and ask about the Veterans Appreciation Dinner Dance, and they'll be ready to sell you tickets. The tickets are $15 each. And if you know somebody who can't afford the $15 ticket, you give my office a call, and the committee finds a sponsor to make sure that that we can get you to to the dinner dance. You can also call my office, and we will get the tickets arranged for you to send your check in, and then we'll have tickets waiting for you at the will call desk. And the students take care of that, and they'll have it in an envelope ready, waiting for you with your name on it.
And those tickets, you know, when you come to this dinner dance, you're not just coming to dance, you're going to have some dinner. And it's a gentleman, Frank.
Frank Godwin.
Yeah, who is the director of food and beverage at the DoubleTree. He volunteers his time to come out and put this whole food thing together for us.
Yeah, I mean, we're upwards of over 700 people that come out for the evening, and Frank Godwin, a professional in the food industry, is able to give us his time each year to help pull this off, and it's really good food.
It is.
I mean, there's not a lot of food left at the end of the evening.
Right, and then we do donate it, stuff that's left over.
Yeah, and the donations will go to the Hope Rescue Mission. Of the food items will go there, and of the ticket sales, then there'll be a huge donation given to this year. That money will be going to Keystone Military Families, a food and clothing pantry located in Shoemakersville on Main Street in Shoemakersville, and they're supporting a little over 60 military veteran families who just don't have enough money to get by on. And especially things like diapers that sometimes folks need. And what breaks Dave's heart and mine is the fact that guardsmen and reservists are also getting supported through this program. The men and women who are serving right now sometimes need this. And so just your contributions, whether you come out, you buy a ticket and you come out, or you'd like to send a check and donate it to the Berks County Veterans Appreciation Committee. We are a 501c19 mm-hmm. organization. We're audited for all the monies that we bring in and allocate out for our expenses. And we do all that right and proper with a certified public accountant to help us with that. But if you would like to donate, you can provide that through the Berks County Veterans Appreciation Committee, and you can send that check to either the Berks County Department of Veterans Affairs or the Wilson High School mm-hmm. in West Lawn.
Dale, to get back to the Keystone,
Military Family?
Yeah, they donate a lot of stuff overseas to the troops that are stationed overseas.
Yeah, they really do, and they're kicking. They've already kicked it off, and they build holiday stockings.
Right.
To send what you and I would say downrange to the troops and the sailors and the airmen,
right.
And the Marines and the Coast Guardsmen who are deployed overseas and, mm-hmm. and can be really surprised when they get something special,
right.
Especially
and
nice. So those are the folks where the donations will support this year is Keystone Military Families.
Right. And I have to say, I was in Iraq myself and was a recipient of one of those care packages.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what, it's the greatest thing when they come at Christmas time because, you're there at Christmas time without your family. And it's so special to have that show up and, it's socks or deodorant or whatever, and it's good stuff. So
yeah. So, again, it's Saturday, November 12th, Wilson High School. It starts at, doors open at 4 p.m. Food is available immediately. 5 o'clock, the formal program starts. Once we're through with the formal program, the buffet lines will open up again and be available throughout the evening. So there'll be plenty of food, and it'll be very good food. I think you're really going to enjoy the music.
Yeah.
Let's Dance. Let's Dance has some singers that will just blow you away. They really are outstanding, and then the musicians are just so on for mm-hmm. this event. We get so many good comments about Let's Dance and the men and women who participate in that band.
And I think one thing that we did forget at this point, we forgot about Brigadier General Eggert, who is our Master of Ceremonies.
Yeah, we should mention her.
Yep.
Brigadier General Carol Eggert is the Vice President at Comcast for Military and Veterans Affairs. She's a retired Army National Guard Brigadier General. She earned a Purple Heart for battle wounds in Iraq, and she is a friend to the committee and
right.
the county, and we're really looking forward to have her as our MC for the evening. Very special person, and very honored that a Brigadier General would come out and be our MC for the event. We've had a lot of Brigadier
yeah.
Generals come out over the years, and we're very honored to have them.
That they support us. Like, and the thing is, this is a great event. For Berks County to have something like this, this is a major event for our veterans. And don't hesitate. Come on out and enjoy every moment of it, because, it just talking about it brings chills to to me, and it's
yeah.
just a great event.
We love having folks come from Boyertown to Bethel and
yep.
Kempton to Carnarvon and everywhere in between come on out for the event. It's not a Wilson event, but we do have a huge support from the Wilson School District. And Dave, as committee members, we can't say enough about
exactly.
about what the school district donates in terms of time and effort and resources to the event, and we're really grateful of their continued partnership.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We wouldn't be able to do it without them.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, we wouldn't have a place big enough.
Yeah. Our honorary chair for this year's event is Bob Harrop, who's the Director of Human Resources at East Penn Manufacturing. And our committee chair for Operations and Planning is Jeff Elliott, himself a retired Army,
yep.
a Pennsylvania Guard colonel,
yep.
Honorary rank of Brigadier General himself. And he is a partner at Kozloff Stout Law Firm here in Wyomissing. And then with our partner organizations on the committee, we pull this off each year to continue to make sure that there's something special like this in Berks County, that the military service does not be taken for granted or goes
right.
forgotten.
That's the main thing, not forgotten.
Yeah, this is a day to celebrate. This is not a solemn day. Veterans Day is a day of celebration
right.
to really reach out and give a handshake, a back slap,
right.
a hug, a kiss on the cheek, whatever it is. And that's the kind of feedback that we get from an event of this magnitude, right, and of the scope that, and the depth of information, right, and style that we put in, into it.
So don't ever forget to thank your service member for serving. And you know, some people say, "Oh, I was only in 2 years," but you know, you served your country and you did a great job.
Yeah, we do. We have an event like this every year. It's usually either the Saturday before Veterans Day. This year, it's the Saturday right after Veterans Day, and Veterans Day itself. There's a major event at City Park at 11 a.m. It's sponsored by the Combined Veterans of Berks Council of Berks County, and that's a group that represents many of the veterans groups out there in Berks County. And this is the official Veterans Day ceremony. It'll be held at Redding City Park at 11 a.m. Veterans Day in law is established for the 11th day of the 11th month at the 11th hour, mm-hmm, all going back to Armistice Day coming out of World War I. And the Combined Veterans Council of Berks County has been putting this ceremony on for decades, and it's a very special event. It's held at the war memorials in what's known as Veterans Grove within Redding City Park at 11 a.m. on Friday, November 11th, the official Veterans Day. So hope you can make that as well. It's good to get everybody out to that event here in Berks County and celebrate the men and women who've served.
That's rain or shine, right?
It is rain or shine. Uh-huh. Well, Dave, I've had a nice half hour here talking with you about things, and appreciate your help, and appreciate your help on the committee too.
Yeah, well, Dale, I appreciate it. I really do, and it's a real honor to be able to do this and to talk about veterans and their service, and to see people given that award and inducted into the Hall of Fame every year, and they so deserve it, you know, and don't ever forget about your veterans.
Thanks, Dave. I appreciate it. Thank you, and this is the VA Showcase.